divisions were ordered to drive further northwest in the direction of Yubar. This armored advance was stopped principally by heavy fire from anti-tank guns and mortars. Those 2 days of intense fighting saw Wittmann destroy 6 enemy tanks, 20 anti-tank guns, 60 guns, 32 trucks, and countless other vehicles. On the 16th of January 1944, both Wittmann and Bobby Voll received the Knight's Cross. Voll was the first soldier holding rank as low as gunner to be awarded such a high decoration. There were now 2 wearers of the Knight's Cross in Wittmann's Tiger. As a member of Wittmann's crew, Voll's success surpassed that of every other gunner in the winter battles of 1943 and 1944. By the 13th of January, he had destroyed 80 tanks and 107 anti-tank guns. Bobby Voll played an important part in the success of Michael Wittmann. With his quick reactions and good eye, he was a master behind the mighty 88 gun. Confident of Voll's ability, Wittmann was not intimidated and would often take on superior numbers of enemy tanks. The two made a fine team, and Voll knew Wittmann's ways to the letter. While a crew's driver, radio operator and loader often changed, the commander and gunner stayed together whenever possible. The commander of a Tiger was closely tied to his gunner, and their actions had to be well coordinated. Making up the rest of Wittmann's crew, posing here for propaganda photographs in January 1944, were Werner Ergang, radio operator, Eugene Schmidt, driver, and Sepp Robner, loader. As the gunner, Voll was of decisive importance. The enemy's next shot could mean the end of them all if his aim was poor.
Balthasar Voll, Michael Wittmann's Tiger gunner, used a rather idiosyncratic method. He preset his sights to 800 meters, which was the kind of average length at which, or distance at which, a Tiger would engage a target, and he would then correct for targets that were closer or further away, using his great experience and essentially intuition in order to fire the gun either higher or lower than the point which was directed by the sight. So a very quick and efficient way of firing the gun.
The rings on the barrel of Wittmann's Tiger each represent 10 tanks destroyed. The Tigers were feared by the Soviets, and the heavy German tanks often drew heavy anti-tank fire in their attacks. They were used as weapons to smash gaps in enemy positions for the grenadiers to move up in support. In countless attacks, they breached anti-tank fronts and destroyed enemy artillery positions. With their high rate of fire, they could outfight any tank on the battlefield. Although few in number, the Tigers performed outstanding feats in the offensive and defensive roles. Constantly under a hail of fire from anti-tank rifles, anti-tank guns and rocket launchers, the Tigers did not get off unscathed. However, thanks to their strong frontal armor, they were difficult to knock out. Often, shells fired by enemy tanks and anti-tank guns simply bounced off their frontal armor. Nevertheless, the Tiger was not invulnerable, and losses always kept pace with the slow trickle of new machines arriving at the front from the hard-pressed German factories. The incredible achievements of Wittmann on the battlefield did not go unnoticed. He was fast becoming a national hero. On the 2nd of February 1944, he was summoned to Hitler's headquarters. Michael Wittmann received the Knight's Cross with oak leaves from the hand of Adolf Hitler. In the course of his conversation with Wittmann, Hitler noticed that he was missing a front tooth as a result of his wounds. He subsequently sent him to his dentist to have the tooth replaced.
Michael Wittmann's success seems to have been based on a number of very great abilities. He is notorious for being able to work out where ambushes were likely to happen. He is described as having a sixth sense by a number of members of his unit for where enemy positions might be, especially where they might be at night. He was able to define where and when danger might appear. But Wittmann the man was very serious about fighting and about the war and about the success. He joined the SS because he believed wholeheartedly in Nazi doctrine, which was not uncommon at the time. But he was able to use that belief, that doctrine, and possibly became a somewhat serious young man. One illustration of that was on frequent occasions he was brought back from the front having been successful to train other troops. And there's one occasion on an icy winter morning when he was drilling some troops, and he had this habit of very sharply bringing his heels together. And on this particular occasion, in doing so, he completely skittled himself over and knocked himself down. And naturally, the troops he was training laughed at him for this. He had them doing extra duties for a month after that. So you get the impression of slightly humorless, but obviously very dedicated tank commander.
Wittmann also took advantage of this brief pause from the fighting to marry his sweetheart, Hildegard Burmester. Once again, it was an unmistakably Nazi event. After the wedding ceremony, performed by the civil magistrate, Wittmann accepted a gift copy of Mein Kampf. A speech was then given by SS-Sturmbannführer Pein, who declared that the philosophy of life of the Teutons still had meaning in their lives. Wittmann's period of calm was to prove short-lived. On June the 6th, 1944, the Allies landed in Normandy. It was here that he would gain lasting fame.
Conditions for German tank crews in Normandy must have been quite horrific. The superiority of the Allied Air Force at the time meant that any movement out of cover was almost always latched upon straight away. If you look at any of the photographs of tank crews during the Normandy campaign, they're frequently looking up at the sky, keeping a very good watch out, large amounts of armour congregating in order to make an attack, which is the only effective way of using armour, would almost certainly have been attacked very quickly by any Allied aircraft. It must have made the conditions quite horrific.
On the morning of June the 13th, 1944, Wittmann was positioned near Villers-Bocage when he surprised a squadron of the County of London Yeomanry. The unsuspecting British troops had stopped for breakfast when Wittmann's Tiger roared up. In no time, the lightning reflexes of Wittmann and Bobby Voll had claimed 12 half-tracks, 3 light tanks, and 6 medium tanks. Wittmann then dashed back and gathered 3 other Tigers and a Panzer IV. At 8 o'clock, a lookout reported to SS-Obersturmführer Wittmann that a large column of enemy tanks was advancing on the Kahn-Villars-Bocage road. Wittmann, who was in cover with his Tiger south of the road, saw a British armoured battalion followed by an English armoured troop carrier battalion advancing for Villers-Bocage. The situation called for immediate action. Wittmann was unable to get orders to his other tanks, who had moved off. Instead, he immediately drove at the English column with his single tank, firing on the move. This rapid intervention initially split the column. From 80 meters, Wittmann destroyed 4 Sherman Firefly tanks, positioned his Tiger next to the column, and drove 10 to 30 meters beside it, firing in his direction of travel along the column. He succeeded in knocking out 12 enemy tanks in a very short time. The accompanying battalion in armored troop carriers was almost completely wiped out. The following German tanks and infantry company took about 130 prisoners, but Wittmann drove on in advance of his company into the town of Villers-Bocage.
It's a very interesting scene to look at when you see how he positioned himself and basically knocked these things off one by one by one. In other words, it was by no means a Turkish shoot, but it was extremely good tactical handling. It's an absolute masterpiece of individual tank fighting and what could be done by an extremely skilled commander with obviously an expert crew and a very good tank, by the way.
Just before the Hotel de Bras d'Or, he destroyed another Sherman, and then found himself facing several enemy tanks at the exit from the town, the Jeanne d'Arc Square. He subsequently turned his Tiger around.